the least Leaf fans got to be happy for 24 hours.
23. This game started early.
Let's go!
Give me what I want!
Kick down the door!
Drew, you are not doing this!
What the?
Not nice! There's a giant head!
You hear yourself?
I made like 2,000 of these. I'd like to have fun.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Guaranteed win, let's go! Oh, no, they lost. Leafs lose 5-3 to the Chicago Blackhawks. Oh, I had some people even say, Steve, is this going to be a one-taker? I haven't decided yet. Let's see. Related question, think you know which way it's going to go? Like, is the top five team going to be the bottom five? What? How many? I've used that joke so many times, and it's still relevant. Then you should go to Sports Interaction. When the puck drops, Sports Interaction has you covered. Pre-game, live betting on all major sports, baseball starting soon, and prop bets. Want to bet? Head to sportsinteraction.com/STPN. That's sportsinteraction.com/STPN. And download the new Sports Interaction app, but only if you're 19 plus. And please bet responsibly. For example, $2 Steve bet $2 on the Leafs to win. They didn't. But $2 Steve also bet $2 on the over in this game because I knew it would be a sloppy, disgusting mess. And it was. All right, Leafs Nation, I feel it. I feel the anger. I feel the stress. I feel the resentment. I feel the anxiety of the entire fan base. It's coursing through us. The Blackhawks. The Blackhawks! Oh, and it's Patrick Kane. It's Patrick Kane! It doesn't help that we talked all that smack just a few days ago. Earlier in this week, the Wednesday game, he looked horrible. Forget scoring a hat trick, it looked like he couldn't even skate. And then in this game, he was mad. He was furious. Lift the Leafs up! But even with a Patrick Kane hat trick, the Leafs should be able to beat the Blackhawks, but it's this stat. It's this stat that has this fan base so fired up! From Sportsnet Stats, gosh, they know how to cut like a knife. Record versus bottom five teams this season. The Bruins are 8-1-0. The Lightning are 7-0-2. The Lightning have had 9 games and they've earned at least a point in all of them. The Leafs are 4-4-2! That is Betsman 500, but that is reality below 500! The Leafs have lost more games against the bottom five teams in this league than they have won! And I'm not great at counting or anything, but we're complaining about the playoff format and everything. The Leafs have played more games against the bottom five teams in the NHL so far this season than the Bruins or the Lightning. They have played 9, the Leafs have played 10. That should be 20 points out of 20. You can't win them all, so how about 18? 18, all right, that might be stretching it. 10! 10! Out of 20! That is what has got this fan base so hot. That is why Leaf fans cannot allow themselves to fully believe. Because you have to understand, it's not like cheering for any other team. It's just not. Listen, if you're young and naive, I get it. And it's a beautiful thing. You're able to just cheer. Hooray for your team because you don't have all these layers and layers of scar tissue. But the older you get, the more Leaf games you watch, the more seasons you watch pass by, you have to let your guard down. You have to peel off all the layers of protection you have put up to protect yourself from this team that keeps hurting you over and over again. There is a vulnerability you have to truly 100% be 100% in. And let me tell you, for this Sunday night loss to the Chicago Blackhawks, it's not that serious. No, really. Like, you see the bait and switch? It's not. I'm sorry, it's not that serious. For all the times I've made backhanded remarks against the crew who always say, well, you can't win every game, this is one of those games. This applies. I gave Sheldon Keefe a little bit of grief, that rhymed, because on Wednesday, after the Leafs beat the Blackhawks, he said, well, I'm not going to evaluate the good or the bad from this game. And after all, it's the Leafs, a top five team, playing the Chicago Blackhawks, a bottom five team. But the situation was a little different. The Leafs were at home and well rested. The Blackhawks were on the road, dog tired, and the Blackhawks. But this game, this was the second half of a back-to-back on the road with travel in a different time zone in an early game. Who approved that? Like, I know back-to-backs happen and there's 82 games every year. You got to play them eventually. But the Leafs started at 7. The puck drop was actually a little after 7 Eastern yesterday. And then after their game, they got on a plane and they flew to Chicago, where they had to play a game the next day at 5 o'clock local. It was 6 o'clock here, it was 5 local. Who the heck, who scheduled that? What's your problem? The reaction to this game from the fan base breaks my heart a little bit, because like I said, it's like a trauma onion. You just gotta peel off. It was 3-1, and it was 4-1, and it was 5-1 if you let the regular season losses bug you. But then Friday night, late Friday night, some of you woke up on Saturday morning, which it's always great to wake up on Saturday morning, because there's that moment where you wake up and you go, it's Saturday morning. You wake up on Saturday morning, and it's a great day to be a Leafs fan. They get Ryan O'Reilly and Noel Achari. They trade basically just draft picks. You didn't lose any of your most significant prospects. And most importantly, you didn't lose Matthew Nyes. You didn't even lose anybody off your roster. And you get Ryan O'Reilly. He beat the Bruins in TD Garden in a game 7 to win the cup. And then they gave him playoff MVP that same night. He lived every Leafs fan's dream. Like you're in your garage, and like you're in your driveway, you're on the street, you're anywhere, and you're taking shots on that is a scenario you would make up. And he did that for real, ironically against Noel Achari, and they were then teammates, and now they're still teammates, between the Bruins, Panthers, and Leafs. Gosh, Noel Achari can't leave the Atlantic Division alone, and it's okay. Welcome, you scored tonight, look at that, I hope you kept the puck. But Leaf fans, wasn't that great? Wasn't that fun? We got Ryan O'Reilly, Noel Achari, you know what? He's gonna shore up the bottom six, and look at this roster, and oh my goodness, John Tavares is on the wing, and Ryan O'Reilly's with Mitch Marner? And he gets a point, and they win, and we're all happy, and it's a wonderful thing. And less than 24 hours later, this loss took that away from you? I won't have it! Listen, I know it's the Leafs. Listen. I know about the 4-4-2 record against bottom 5 teams in this league, but we're talking about this one game, this one piece of garbage game. Who on earth scheduled this thing? Piece of crap game. Can I show you a clip? I noticed this immediately. I stayed after the game so I could watch Sheldon Keefe's presser, because I've been like, you know what? I was like you. I sat there and I went, what are you gonna say, Sheldon? It's a, does this one matter, Sheldon? Are we gonna break this one down, Sheldon? You thought last Wednesday's didn't matter, Sheldon? And the moment I saw this clip, my guard dropped and I wasn't mad anymore. Here's Sheldon Keefe getting asked about his team's performance.
I just thought we were clearly a very tired group right from the start, and made tired mistakes.
Well, there's some things that, you know, some things that we did, you know, when you're tired, you gotta be really smart and structured and all of that, and some of the clean looks we gave up tonight are a result of just not being smart. Like, you're right there in the game, so credit to our guys for that, but, you know, we didn't play a good enough or smart enough game here today to make up for what we were lacking in energy.
Did you see what I saw in that clip? That dude's exhausted. Dude, I've looked like that. I've felt like that. I could feel what he felt like through the camera. If that's what he felt like, imagine what the players felt like. Dude, imagine what Ryan O'Reilly and Noel Achari felt like. They were on this magical pilgrimage from St. Louis, and Ryan O'Reilly had to go back and get the equipment, and he found it, and they flew like a fly-by-night thing to land on the ground, and they get to play in this game, and they play for the Leafs, and it's a big time, and hey, John, do you want to play wing? And that silliness, and then they do it again the next day, and by the end of it, I think I'd like to go home and sleep. But Steve, what about the playoffs? What about the playoffs? This isn't a playoff game. I guarantee you, if it was, the Leafs would have beaten the Blackhawks. I do. It's 2023. They would have won. It's 2010, 2013, 2015. You can't take those things away from the Blackhawks. It's 2023. Patrick Kane got a hat trick. I bet he did. I bet he did. He was embarrassed on Wednesday. He should have been embarrassed. He wasn't good. He wasn't good. And this game, Elliot Friedman was sure to point out, well, he was mad. He didn't like what people were saying about him, and he addressed the rumors, and he basically said, like, Toronto was never really on the radar. Be careful who you listen to, whatever. He had a hat trick in this game, in part because he was mad about people talking about his hip and his performance this season. And I said it on the podcast, like, Patrick Kane's a hard guy to bet against. I mean, he's got three cups. He's got scoring titles, Hart trophies. He's a pretty good player. He had 92 points last season. But the reason people have been saying, I don't know about this Patrick Kane guy at the deadline, is because most nights he doesn't look how he did tonight. Against an exhausted team with a starting goalie who says stuff like this.
You were a little bit sick, I think, going into the break too, right? So was it the same thing or something?
No. In this break, I got some cough. Right now, like, more stomach and sick. It's not great. It's hard day in the yeah.
Dude, why did Ilya Samsonov play in this one? He didn't look good, and after that quote, we know why. This is the one thing I'm gonna get mad about with the Leafs. It was nonsensical to play Ilya Samsonov in this game. Absolutely nonsensical. We knew heading into yesterday that he was ill. He had some sort of ailment. That's why Joseph Woll played. How good was Joseph Woll, by the way? Here's a round of applause for Joseph Woll. And Eric Shellgren was backing up. If there is a team in the NHL worth playing your fourth string goaltender against, it's the Blackhawks. You should have done it. Against the Blackhawks. Matt Murray was put on LTIR yesterday. Yesterday! Samsonov's gonna be playing a bunch of games coming up. Rest him! He just finished pooping a lot! That's what he said! The source was him. That's what he said. Hey, stomach bugs have been flying around Ontario, alright? Have you had it? How was that? How was that? Did you feel like playing an NHL game the next day? Well, Steve, I doubt it was yesterday. Did you feel like playing an NHL game 2 days later? Even three? The point is, they didn't have to do that. Like, at all. Dude, you're playing Tuesday. Wait for Tuesday. You didn't need to do this. Let the dude rehydrate, for crying out loud. He didn't look good, and it's no wonder he didn't look good. And that's who the Blackhawks beat in this one. That's who they lit up with a hat trick. Ah, yeah, hang that banner. How the mighty have fallen. 2015 must feel ages ago at this point. That's Rich coming from a Leafs fan. Pretend I wasn't a Leaf fan. I was just wearing, like a generic NHL jersey. Like John Scott at the actual NHL All-Star game. Still can't believe they did that to him. Imagine I'm not a Leafs fan. It's just true. And you know what? No, I don't want to take everything away from Patrick Kane. I mean, first goal, dude can snipe. Second goal, Justin Hall tripped. I do not see it. And he scores a frankly terrible goal. Like, Samsonov should not have allowed that. But he, again, with the poop. And the third goal, it's, you know, he allowed Kane to bank the puck off him. And what I think is amazing is it almost happened to him again. Later in the game, Samsonov was horrific. I cannot believe he only gave up 4. But that's not how he usually looks, because he usually does not have rampant diarrhea. His words, sort of, not mine. Now, not everyone has the played less than 24 hours ago excuse. Connor Timmins was out there turning me into the Tyra Banks meme. We were all rooting for you! How dare you! Falling over himself, Connor, for crying out loud. You can't blame everything on they were tired or they were sick and pooping themselves. And I find it very hard to believe that Samsonov is the only guy who had that bug. My wife teaches kindergarten and I have a toddler in daycare. Illnesses go through this house like a brush fire. And you don't have to diminish the Blackhawks' accomplishments. That fan base has not enjoyed the last little while. And that may very well be the last great Patrick Kane moment in Chicago. We don't know how this is going to pan out. He could get traded tomorrow. We never know. But heck of a send-off for him. But that's Blackhawks fans. Leafs fans, this video, these videos, are for you. Yes, their record against bottom five teams sucks and is awful, but this one game, all the circumstances around it, the scheduling, the sick goalie being mystifyingly played, but the fact that you were so happy less than a full day ago, I'm not going to let you forget that feeling. You hold on to that feeling. Dubas rewarded this team with their biggest deadline blockbuster since 2004, nearly 20 years ago, because they deserved it. And they might not even be done. Dude, there are names out there. Like, Kampf has all of a sudden played his, like, two best offensive games in a long time. Engvall scored last game. He's looking pretty good. Kerfoot, I mean, he's too expensive for a fourth liner, but he's a pretty gosh darn good fourth liner. This team. Oh, the thing about getting hurt is you don't want to get hurt again. And this is so stupid, but fandom is stupid. This team is worth letting down your guard for. Because why not?
Why not? What else are you going to do?
I'm going to delete Netflix. Put your money where your mouth is. And once you do that, what are you going to do?
I'm going to stop watching sports. No, you're not!
They got Ryan O'Reilly practically yesterday. They won literally yesterday. Remember how you felt? Chill. It's a holiday if you're in Ontario. Relax. Tuesday's coming. That's the next game. And we treat it as its own little thing. But the yelly screamy man, every now and then, has to remind you to relax. I think this is one of those times where you do that. So, for now, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you liked this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. It's all good.